want you to know if one part of it stops working, it affects the whole body. I don't know if you ever had things that happen to your body. I've got people I know that have had strokes. Y'all ain't gonna talk. When they have strokes, amen, the worst thing about strokes and other things is to lose the function of a member and not have any control over it. Some people have strokes, they lose control and function of their arm. When you see them when they walk, they're walking with their arm to the side. And it's not because they want it to be that way, but because that member has ceased to function. And eventually, if you're not careful, it may affect another part. But notice that many times, even when they have a stroke, and that member ceased to function, sometimes when they get ready to operate the member that's not functioning right, every now and then they will take this arm and raise up this arm to make it work. Y'all ain't gonna talk to me. Which means, amen, don't ever count another member out, because you may need it after a while. And so what the enemy has done is got us in the body. And all of us, the day is a day that the body is not fighting the devil. It's not fighting the enemy. But they're fighting one another. We've got caught up into the things of our denominations. We've got caught up into, amen, what group we're with. And so now the body is fighting one another. And so the world is sitting back looking at the church fighting one another. The world is looking at us fighting each other. The world is looking at us slapping our face. The world is looking at us beating our bodies. But I hear the Lord saying, it's time now to bring the body in to unity, the unity of the faith. It's time for every member to know your rightful place. Know that wherever you are, that I'm not going to fight anymore. I'm not going to fight the body. I'm not going to kill my body. Nobody would do injury unless you're suicidal to your own body. You wouldn't take rat poison. You wouldn't drink amen. You wouldn't drink fluids and stuff that would kill you because you want to live and you want your body to live. Well, it's time for the body to stop fighting and taking things that will kill us and make us non-effective. But I don't know about you, but I want a healthy body. I want the Lord to work on us that we'll be healthy in the spirit, that we'll be healthy in the world, that when the world looks at us, they'll see a healthy body, the body of Christ that's not divided, the body of Christ that's not carried away with every wind and doctrine. We don't get carried away with every new thing that comes on the scene. We don't get carried away. Amen. We don't let things make us backslide so quick. We don't let things make us leave God and leave the church so quick. But we get stable. We get in God. We get in Him. And tell the devil that I know it's the body of Christ and we're working on health. Well, how do we get healthy? The way we get healthy, the Bible says iron sharpens iron. We need to work on one another. We need to help each other. And then we need to pray and read the word of God. We need to get in the scripture so we can get healthy bodies. You talking about taking pills. You talking about taking vitamins. You talking about taking herbs. You talking about golden seal and all this other stuff. You talking about what you need to take, what you need spiritually to take. You need to get a dose of this Bible. You got 66, amen, books in it. You need to grab a hold to it. Take this word and chew on it. Take this word and eat on it. It'll make you healthy. It'll get what's ailing you. It'll move out the sickness that's in your body. It'll move out the things that's in your body. It'll move the impurities out that's in your body. Get in the word. Get in the word. Y'all ain't gonna help me preach it. I said get in the word. Stop looking. Lord, I'm gonna get in trouble. Stop looking for a life class. Stop looking. I can't get no help. Stop looking for life classes. Stop looking for reality TV. Stop looking for somebody to fix your life. Get in the word. Let the word fix you. It'll fix you. Yes, it will. It'll fix you. It'll make your body. It'll make it healthy. It'll make your body. It'll make it move. It'll make your body. It'll strengthen you. Yes, it will. It'll strengthen you. It'll strengthen you from head to toe. It'll strengthen you. Yes, it will. Is it anybody? Do you want to exercise in the spirit? Do you want to exercise in the Holy Ghost? You want a healthy body? I just don't want to be in church, but I want a healthy body. I want my body to be healthy in the spirit. Not only the body of Christ, but my body. I want it healthy. A healthy body. Touch somebody. Tell them, neighbor, we need to a healthy body. We need God to touch us. What we need is the Bible. What we need less opinions. We don't need everybody's opinion. We don't need what everybody else thinks. We don't need to know what you wrote in your book. We don't need to know to turn the page 37 in your book. But what we need is to grab this book and read through it and find out what did it say. It said, if you live with me, I'll bless you. It said, many of the afflictions of the righteous, but the Lord shall deliver out of them all. It said, my God, no weapon formed against you shall prosper. It said, y'all better help me preach. It said, if you hang in there, I'll bless you. I'll move for you. We need. We need, look at somebody and tell them we need a healthy body. Tell them we need one another. Yes, yes, yes. I heard. The songwriter said, I need you, you need me. I need you to survive. I got the clothes, but don't say it. If you don't mean it, don't be a hypocrite. If you don't mean it, don't say it. But if you mean it, look at somebody. Tell them, neighbor, I need you to survive. I need you. I need you when I'm hurting. I need you when I'm down. I need you when I'm out of it. I need you when I feel like giving up. I need you when I'm fatigued. I need you when I'm restless. I need you when I'm about to throw in the towel. I need you. God, I'm through, DL. I said, God wants a healthy body. God wants a strong body. God wants a together body. God wants us together. Tell the world we're together. Tell the world we're healthy. Tell the world we're strong. Yeah.